महाकाय सूर्यकोटिशाक्तवनिर्विघ्नं कुरुमेदेव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वतीमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणि विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाव्यसंपृक्तो वागर्थप्रतिपत्ते जगतः पितरो वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरो येनाक्षरसमाम्नायमधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृष्णं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनेय नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम् धातुर्ब्रह्मैव संप्रोक्तो जीव आख्यात उच्यते प्रकृति कृसुबन्ताधिर्धातुब्रह्मात्मने नमः। शुक्लां ब्रह्म विचारसार पर्वमाद्यां जगद्व्यापिनीं वीणा पुस्तकधारिणीं अभयदां जाड्यान्धकारापहां हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्दे तां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं बुद्धिप्रदां शारदां नत्वा सरस्वतीं देवीं शुद्धां गुण्यां करोम्यहं पाणिनीय प्रवेशाय लघुसिद्धान्तकौमुदी। सो दि सूत्र वी आर लुकिंग एट इस मेस्ड अप हियर। सो दि सूत्र वी आर लुकिंग एट इस Go back and have a look. Vasu sramsu dhamsu anadusam anaduham daha. So saha padanam. So this sakara at the end of vasu samsru dhamsu ityadi and anadu hakara also. Basically last letter will be replaced by dakara. Now in that what has been said padanam. So at the end of pada. So all these should be at the end of this shashti bahuvachana here. So Shashti Bhavachana and this is Shashti Bhavachana. So Tadantavidhi is applying and all these words should be at the end of the pada. That's the idea. Therefore, Lagukara raises a question regarding why this Padanta has been added there. Padante kim, why Padanam, Padante. So there he gives a counter example. Example Srastam. So this Sramsdhatu itself but with a Kta Pratyaya. Thereby what will happen, this Ta Pratyaya is a Kit Pratyaya, one, Nishtha, Ta Tavatu Nishtha, and then Nishtha is the Sutra which ordains the Ta Pratyaya after the Dhatu, Dhatu Pratyaya Parashcha. This Srams Dhatu now what happens is that it is followed by Kit Pratyaya and this Srams is not at the end of the Pada because the Pada Sanya is for this, this is what is the Pratiparika Sanya in fact, this is a Dhatu, Srams is a Dhatu, this much is a Pratipadika and then Pada will be when you add a supratya when you add, then this entire entity will become padam, suptingantam padam. And there is no reason for any other pada sanya to apply to srams dhatu. So srams is a dhatu now. It is at the end of itself is a dhatu, it is not at the end of the pada. Thereby, anitam halopadaya kniti na lopaha, nakarasya lopaha bhavati. So this nakara, this is a lupta shashti nirdesha, nakarasya lopaha bhavati. So this kiti pare. This is a nimitta for upadhayaha nakarasya. Upadhaya shashti. So upadhayaha nakarasya lopa bhavati halaha. So anaditam. So here if you look at here, now this anuswara is born of nakara. So this anuswara which is born of nakara is seen as nakara and tasya lopa bhavati. Therefore srams will become sras and sras plus ta kakarasya. Itvat. So kakara is an it letter, it goes away, tasya lopa, so sras plus ta. So what will that is the example srastam here. And thereby what will get is srasta is the pratipadika. When you decline in neutral, you get srastam. Similarly, what ukhayaha sramsateti ukhasrat, what happens here? This ukhasrat, there is a quip pratya in the end, and thereby ukhasras here, this nalopa takes place, and then ukhasras will also not have nakara there and there will be no dakara adesha. That's the idea, there is no dakara adesha to the sakara. Parnani dhvamsate iti parnadhvata. So parna, there is an upapada tatpurusha. So parna plus shas, so just amount shas, so second case plural, this becomes karma. So upapada tatpurusha karmani upapadeshati. So when parna is a karma upapada to dhvams dhatu, then it takes a quip pratya by quitcha and gives out an upapada tatpurusha samasa. So parnadhvas means that which fells the leaves. So parnadhvas, what happens there is that this also will have a declension as an exception there. Another example is Tura Sa. This is not an example, this is an introduction of another Halanta Pullinga Shabda to introduce the next sutra. So Laghukara is going to introduce another sutra using this Tura Sa. What is Tura Sa? So here you look at Turam means Vegavantam and Sahayati Abhivavati Iti Turashat. So that it's a causative. It's a Sahayati. So Sahadatu Sahayati is called causative Nich. So Hetumati Nich will give you Nich. So Shahamarshane and Shahamarshane Dhatu to endure with a causative. So to cause to endure. Not to endure, but to cause to endure is a Dhatu, which is a derived Dhatu. So this Saha is a Bhadayaha Dhatava, by that it will get Dhatu Sanya. But Sahi, which is Saha plus Nich, will get Dhatu Sanya by Sanadhyantaha Dhatavaha. So Sanadhyanta Dhatava will give Sahi as a new Dhatu in the meaning of to cause to endure. Now using this Dhatu, you are going to derive an Upapada Tatpurusha, Tura plus Nyas, then Sahi plus Kvip. This Nyas is, looks like a copy paste error everywhere. This should be second case singular, so it should be Am. It should be Am, not Nyas. It should be Am. Because Turam, it is Turam Sahayati. So Turam is second case singular. It's a Karmani Upapada. So it should not be Nyas, it should be Am. So Tura plus Am, Sahi plus Sahi plus Kvip. Kvipcha will give you the Kvip Pratya, which makes a Karta out of the Saha Dhatu when Karma, Tura is Karma to this Dhatu Sahi. Not to Saha but Sahi, causative. So you get a Krutadita Samasa, due to Samasa it becomes a Upapada, Tatpurusha it becomes a Samasa and thereby Pratipadika. So Tura Sahi, all this Supodhatu Pratipadika look, Nyas will go away and you'll have Tura plus Sahi plus Veyapruktase, this is a zero Pratya. So you'll get Tura Sahi and then Veyapruktase after that you have this Nera Niti Lopaha. So this Ikara will also go away, you'll get Tura Saha. So Tura Saha. And then there is another sutra, Annesha Api Drishyate, some Dirgha takes place, Turasaha will become Turasaha. So anyway, our focus is not this area, this is just, you know, so go through the sutra, so some samskara is there when we come across these sutras later. So Turasaha is the Pratipadika, by Kruttadita Samasascha, the Nimitta there is Samasa. So since it is a Pratipadika, now you can decline. And how will it decline now? That is our focus area of Halanta Pullinga Shabda Turasaha. So Tura Saha plus Su Halnyabhyo Dirghat Sutisya Pruktam Hal Lupyate Lopaha. So this Hal Hakara, this Hakara is Hal. So after a Hal, this Su Sakara will go away and then you will get Tura Saha. Hodha will give you Hakara to becoming Dhakara. And then Jhalam Jashwante will give you Tura Saad. Now Va Avasane will give you Tura Sat also, but before that what happens is that this Sakara undergoes change by the next sutra, which is introduced by Laghukara as to what? Sahe Sadas Saha Murdhanya Adesha. So Vidhi Sutra, what is Saha Dhatu? The Saha Marshane Dhatu is there, Shaha Marshane, the Shanmukh Shakara, outside the Dhatu Pada becomes Sakara. So Dhatu Adehe Shaha Saha Nodaha. So no naha. So the shakara will become sakara after the in the prakriya avastha when you take the dhatu outside the dhatu pata and nakara will become nakara. So that's the idea. Sahe, now this shaha marshane is actually saha dhatu outside the dhatu pata. This saha, sahe sada. This sad, these are not in samanadhikaran. Just because they are in shashti ekvachana, they are not samanadhikaran. This saha dhatu, which has become Saad. So the Saad form of Sahadhatu, when it is there, Tasya Sakaras, all these are Shashti Ekvachana. So basically what it means is that Sakara of the Sahadhatu, which has taken the Saad form, will get Murdhanya Adesha. So Murdhanya is the Adesha. So this Saha, Sakara will not always become Murdhanya, but when it has taken a Saad form, that Sakara will become Murdhanya. So the Sakara of the Sad sa dhatu which has taken the sad form will take murdhanya shanmukh shakara adesha. And here we have what? We have turasah. So turasah has become turasad in prathama ekvachana. So that sad form of the sa dhatu will cause sakara to become murdhanya, and thereby what will happen? This turasad, this sad sakara will become shakara by sahe sad saha. This is our sutra murdhanya adesha. Then vavasanichar. So turashad is one form, turashat, dakara becoming takara, which is chartvam, is the second form. Then vakaranta pullinga shabda sudiv. What is sudiv? Su is shobhana or shushtu. So shobhana, su shobhana dyauhu, divdhatu there, dyauhu is equal to akasha. Akasha yasya sa sudyauhu. So, Dyau, Akasha or Prakasha also, I don't know, Akasha, generally Prakasha is the meaning of Dyau. This may be Prakasha here. So anyway, I'll just, there is no Shobhana Akasha yasya, does not make much sense. So Shobhana Prakasha yasya, this is what I recall. And anyway, it is all trivial, it is meaning, which is not the focus of Vyakrana. So, and since we are anyway lagging, I'll not go into details. Those who are interested can look up, please. So Su plus Su, first case Shobhana is in first case, so Su Pratya. Then Devadhatu is taking Su, first case, so Su, this Su is Pradi, so with that Su, then Su Pratya, Su Pratya, then Devadhatu plus Su. So this is how the formation, Anekam Anya Padarthe Bahuri Samasa. So this is the Bahuri Samasa formation, Anekam Anya Padarthe. Many words can go together in a single Vigraha Vakya, and they'll all come together as a Bahuri Samasa. In the meaning of what? One who has Shobhana Prakasha. So, you then again Krutthadya Samasascha Supodhatu Pratipadika, all this, you keep on repeating, there will be a lot of samskara, and hopefully we'll remember when we need. That's why we repeat these. So, Su plus Div, these Pratyas will go away within the Dhatu or the Pratipadika. So, our Nimitta is Pratipadika. Because it is a Pratipadika, the Supratyas will have look. They'll go away and you'll have Sudev. This is our Pratipadika, which is Vakaranta. In Pullinga, what happens? Sudev plus Su when you're declining. Then what happens is Diva out. This is the Vidhi Sutra. Then this this Dhatu Div Dhatu, Divaha, this Dhatu ho, out Adesha Bhoti. Taparakarana has been done. So, how is the Adesha? When? Saupare. When Su Pratyaya follows, which is a Prathama Ekvachana. So when that follows, then O is the Adesha for Div. It's an Antadesha. So what will happen? Antadesha, Vakara will be replaced by O, by Diva out. Supare. Saupare. Saupare is when Su Pratyaya follows. Saptami Ekvachana of Su. Then Sudhi Vakara will become Sudhi Aukara. So Sudhi and O. Iko Yanichi will apply, you will get Yanadesha, Ikara will become Yakara, and you will get Sudyav. Sudyav plus Su, Rutto Visarga, Rutto Visarga. Saso Jisho Ru, 8266 and 8315 is Visarga. Karavasanyo Visarjaniya, you will get Sudyav. This is Prathama Ekochana. Then in Dhyuvachana, what will happen? Prathama Dhyuvachana, Sudyav plus Au, just Varna Milana, you will get Dhyuvachana. So Sudyav Hu, Sudivau, Sudivaha. Sudivam, Sudivau, Sudivaha. This is the declension. So if you go back and see, unfortunately this table is placed anywhere, sometimes at the end, sometimes at the beginning, sometimes in the middle. So if you look at this, only here you get this Su, Saupare. When Su Pratyaya is following, Saupare, what do you get? You get Dyau. Why? Aut Adesha is there. Everywhere else, wherever there is an Ajadi Pratyaya, meaning what? Either in Sarvanamasthana where there is Ajadi Pratyaya following, or in Asarvanamasthana also where Bhasanya is there, Ajadi Pratyaya is following, you get this Div retains, and then you may have Varnamilana. That's all. You have Varnamilana. All these places you have just Varnamilana. The grayed out parts are the where you have Padasanya. So where the Padasanya is there, that time what will happen? That time there is an additional Adesha which is neither out here nor, you know, leaving it aside as Div itself, where there is Varna Milana. So in the Padasthana, whenever there is a, in Asarvanama sthana wherever there is, in fact, sarvanama, if you look at it, sarvanama sthana is sud, sud anapunsakam, the first five. And after that, all of that is asarvanama sthana. So swadishu asarvanama sthane padam. So all these are padam, and then yachibham, therefore ajadin asarvanama sthana, where getting the bhasanya. So there all the div form is maintained. But wherever there is asarvanama sthana, there padasanya is retained. And that place will have another sutra, which is ukar, giving ukaradesha, not out, but ukaradesha. Therefore, sudiv, vakara will be replaced by ukara. There will be yand sandhi, you will get sudyu. So sudyubhyam, sudyubhi, sudyubhyaha, and sudyushu. These are the forms here. So there is a second sutra for this divdhatu, particular divdhatu, which is the vidhi sutra, says diva ut. Diva ut. So divdhatu ho. उत आदेश होते वोट उत आदेश तप तपरकरण उकार आदेश होती इत्यादि पदांते पदांते क्वालिफिकेशन इज देर पदांते मीन्स वॉट वेन एवर देर इज स्वादिशु पदा काइंड ऑफ संज्ञा रिटेड सो दिस अंगा विल बी कॉल्ड एज पदा देन दिस दिव धातु एट द एंड ऑफ द पदा विल टेक उकार आदेश अंतादेश अलोमतस्य देयरफॉर वकार विल बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय उकार एंड देन देयर विल बी इको यणचि यण संधि एंड यू विल गेट Vakara becoming Ukara, then Ikara Ukara Sandhi is, both will be replaced by Yakara, Ikara will be replaced by Yakara, and then Varnamela will use Sudyu, Sudyubhyam Ityadi. We looked at the table there. Then Rephanta, Rephanta Pullinga, Chatur Shabda has been taken as an example. So what happens, Chatur being four, it has Bahuvachana, so it will always have only Bahuvachana form. So Chatur, 4. Nitya Bahuvachana. So it will decline only in the Bahuvachana. So just in plural, first case plural, what will happen is Chatur plus Jas. You have Chatur as a Nimitta in the Sutra. Chatur Anudahor Aam Udatta. Aam is the Adesha, Udatta is the Swara Adesha. So Sarvanamasthane. Sarvanamasthane is what? Here it is Sud. Sut. Anapunsakam. So sut suaujas am out. So jas is part of suaujas am out. So jas is third out of these first five pratyas. Therefore it is sarvanamasthana. So when sarvanamasthana pratyaya is following, then what will happen? Am adesha. Chatur will take am, not adesha, agama. Sorry. Am is makara is an ith letter. So am is an agama. Therefore midachontyat paraha will apply. Midachuntat Yat Paraha Midachu Midachuntat Paraha. Thereby, after the last vowel, Aam will come in. Makara is an eighth letter by Halantyam Tasilopa. So, A is the content of the Adesha. So, Repha before the Repha, where after the Ukara, Ukara is the Chatur, Ukara is the last vowel, so antya ach. After the antya ach, this mit am will be paraha, will be thereafter. So you will get chatu plus a repa. So chatu plus a, u and a will have yan sandhi, you will get va iko yanchi vakara chatvar. So chatvar plus as chatur will become what? Chatvaraha rutto visarga. So chatvaras chatvaraha. So chatvaraha is the first case and second case, first case form. Why is not second case? Because second case is shas is outside of sut. Being outside of sut, being out of sut, it is what? It is not sarvanamasthana. Therefore, what? Not sarvanamasthana. Not being sarvanamasthana, there is no prapti of the earlier sutra. Not sarvanamasthana. Therefore, this sarvanamasthane pratyaye pare am agama, which was ordained for chatur, will not be ordained anymore. Therefore, is not applicable anymore. Therefore, chatur plus shas is chatur plus as. Rutta visarga will give you just varna melana and then rutta visarga. Chatur plus as is chaturaha. So chatvaraha, chaturaha, then चतुर्भि चतुर्भ्य देर इज नथिंग एल्स टू डू देर जस्ट वर्ण मिलन एंड वॉट एवर इज ए संधि सूत्र पदांत सूत्र सो चत्वारः चतुरः चतुर्भि चतुर्भिस् चतुर् ऋतविसर्ग ओनली चतुर्भ्य चतुर्णाम हियर देर इज डबल नकार और सिंगल नकार सो देर इज अ सो चतुर्षु सो दोज आर ऑल सूत्रास वी हैव सीन अर्लियर देन विधि सूत्र फॉर वॉट इफ यू लुक एट इट हियर what are so here I am sorry this this may not be seen so there is another agama which comes in nudagama so this nudagama is what particularly for this chatur shabda which is mentioned in the sutra shat and chatur so for chat shat and chatur shat is 6 chatur is 4 so shat chatur bhyascha amaha nut so amaha nut am will take nudagama and nudagama is what tit agama therefore adyanto takito adi agama And it is ordained for Aam, Aamaha Bhavati, for Aam Pratyah. Therefore, it will go and sit here at the Adi of Aam Pratyah. So, Aam will become Naam. And then what will you get? Chaturnaam. Chaturnaam and then Nattvam will give you Chaturnaam. Chaturnaam. At this junction, this Nattva Sutra is introduced. Vidhi Sutra. Rashabhyam Lona Samanapade. This is... This is strange. Just give me one moment. Strangely, the padas are wrongly written. That this is not right. So, Rashabhyam Nonaha. Nonaha. Naha is the Adesha. So, this not Nonaha. Nonaha. Although it can be explained, but the Sutra is not right. We both are, you know, Naha and Naha. They are interchangeable as well. In Anvaya, but in Sutra you cannot interchange. The Sutra has to be in the same order. So, Rashabhyam Nodha Samanapade. Nodha. So, what will happen here? We have seen the Sutra. Rape and Shakara are Nimitta. Rape or Nimitta Shakara. This will become Nimitta for Nakara to take Natvam. And this is immediately following. Only when you have immediately for Rashabhyam Panchami Dvivachana. So, Naha Naha. Naha is Shashti Ekvachana and Naha is Samana Pade, they should be in the same Pada. So, Samana Pade is an Avyaya here, mentioned as an Avyaya. So, what happens is that Samana Pade, Saptami, say 0 has been written, Saptami Ekvachana, it is actually Samanancha, Adash, Padancha, Samana Padam, Tasmin. So, it should be, I don't know why this 0 is marked, written as an Avyaya, so very strange. So, it is not right, Saptami Ekvachana, it is written as an Avyaya, but it is clearly Samana Pade. When there is a samana pada and you can say it's a adhikarane saptami so not para saptami adhikarane saptami in the same pada when you have repha or shakara immediately followed by a nakara then that nakara will take natvam murdhanya natvam murdhanya nakara so it will become this is what is called natnam so there is an this is what we have this yaraha dve This is what we had seen as Achorahabhyam Dve. This we have seen earlier. That's why I said that Chaturnam that we have seen earlier. Again, earlier as to when we have seen it, I myself do not remember because we have long 2.5 years break and then we did a recap. That also has had breaks. But we have seen this. So generally what Anachicha and these kind of sutra, if you look at Achorahabhyam Dve, Yarahadve, Va, Vibhasha. And around that area you will find Anachicha also. So these are the places where you will find where is there is a duplication of letters. So the what is taking what is sthani yar is sthani. So achaha rahabhyam this repha and hakara repha and hakara here we have repha in chaturnam we have repha. So that chatur repha after the repha what should have you should have a yar and before the repha what should you have you should have an ach so achaha rahabhyam repha or hakara which is sandwiched between an ach preceding ach and a following yar letter will cause the yar to optionally double so that is the meaning and therefore this chaturnam here what is the form here chatur repha So you have repha which is preceded by what? Ukara. So here you have, I'll separate this chat, chatur, ur. This ur here, ukara is an ach, and repha is there. Out of repha and hakara, repha is there, and then you have a here letter, nakara. Then you have aam. So what happens is that this yar, this is a yar preceded by repha or hakara, and which is in turn preceded by an ach. So this achaha rahabhyam after a repha, rat, because repha is there, we can say rat. Rat kim bhavati yaraha dve va vibhasha. So nakara can optionally double, and thereby you get this form of two nakaras. Then chatur plus sup, saptami, bahuvachana, what happens there? Here visarga for repha is prapta by what? Kharavasana visarjaniya. Chatur, kharavasana, because khari pare, sakara is a khar letter. So this being a khar letter, khari pare, kasya khari pare, khara avasana yoho, there is no avasana, but khara letter is following. So visarjani kasya rephasya, this repha can become visarga by this sutra, but it is restricted by the next niyamana sutra. The niyamana sutra is introduced, niyama sutra rosupi. So rosupi, repha has been mentioned, khara avasana yoho visarjaniya, but roho supi, when supratya follows, visarjaniya adesha is only for ru, not repha. So here we have chatur is ending with ru, with repha. Both ru and repha content is repha. Repha is repha itself. And ru content, ukara will go away by upadeshi janna siketa tasya lopa. So repha is the content of ru. But what is the sutra saying? It is limiting the application of visarjan. See 8.3.16 and our... Let me just go to Ashtadhyayi. See, look at the sutra we have been regularly using, Rutva Visarga. So Rutva Visarga or sutra for Visarga is Kharavasani or Visarjaniya. This is the sutra we have been using. So this sutra 8.3.15 gives you Visarga Adesha for what? Raha. So Raha. Rori, from Rori, this repha is going to 15. So kharavasana yoho, when khari avasane cha pare, that's what, if you split it, khari avasane va or cha pare, kasya visarjani adesha bhoti rephasya. Rephasya visarjani adesha bhoti. So chatur su, su sakara is khar, therefore repha could have become visarga visarjaniya by this 8.3.15. However, this rosupi is saying, this roho means what? Not raha. Raha is replaced by roho. So thereby there's a niyama, the repha will not take, which repha? The repha will become visarga, but not plain repha. Only ru repha will become visarga when supi pare, when the supratya follows. So there is a restriction made here as to, so there is a restriction made here as to when this supratya supratya follows, this supi supratya follows, then this supratya will cause only the ru repha to become visarga, not this. So this plain repha chatur is a plain repha ending letter, which is ending meaning it is followed by sup. So that kind of a word, repha ending word, will not take visarga. So roho eva visarga supi pare, when sup pratyaya follows, then only ru repha will take visarga, not plain repha. And chatur has a plain repha, this repha has not come by ru, therefore there is no visarga, but chatur repha will remain. And then आदेश प्रत्ययो इनको सह मूर्धन्य अपदान्तस्य, अपदान्तस्य शुड बी सेड हियर, अपदान्तस्य, देयर इज अनदर अनुति, अपदान्तस्य कस्य? सकारस्य, सह अपदान्तस्य सकारस्य इनको हो, इनको इज पंचमी द्विवचन, व्हेन इन और कु प्रीसीड्स, देन व्हाट विल हैपन, मूर्धन्य आदेश, विच सकार दो, नॉट ओनली अपदान्त, बट इट शुड ईदर बी एन आदेश और इट शुड बी अ प्रत्यय. Here what is said, this supratya sakara is a pratyaya sakara. So this will become nimitta. And which is the nimitta in Indarku? The nimitta is ku is what? This here it is chatur. So chatur repha is found in ind. So ind is the nimitta. Why ind is what? Not ai un ind, but the second nakara. So second nakara in Maheshwara Sutra is what? Hayavarat lund, lund nakara. So hayavarat has a repha. Therefore this repha, which is an ind, becomes a nimitta for this apadanta pratyaya sakara to take murdhanya adesha, and you will get chaturshu. Now what? Achorahabhyam dve is prapta again. Why? Because repha is there, and then so shasasar yar has shasasar also. This shakara can also double now, because achorahabhyam dve can apply being 8446 after 8359. So in the Tripadi 8446 achuraha abhyam dve can apply just like in Chaturnam. Thereby a Nisheda Sutra is given as to Sharochi Nadve. Sharochi, Sharochi, Nadve is Anurti. Sharochi what? Sharaha, Sharaha, Achipare, Na, Kimna Bhavati, Dve, Dve Na Bhavataha. There is no Dvitva. So when there is an Ach, so Achorahabhyam Dve is Prapta. Achorahabhyam is 8449. 8449 negates that as to Ach Repha Hakara. What do you have here now? In Chaturshu, Chaturshu, you have this Shakara, which is a Yar. Shakara is a Yar. Repha is there, Repha Hakara. So Repha or Hakara, this condition is met. Then Ukara is an Ach. Just give me a moment. Somebody at the door. So we'll have this every class at this hour. We may have interruption of the maid coming in. So, a moment. किचन मध्ये हे बाल्टी आहे. सो व्हॉट विल हॅपन इज दिस इज प्राप्त अचोरहाभ्याम द्वे यरह द्वे षण्मुख शकारस्य द्वे इज प्राप्त. बट व्हॉट हॅपन्स शरह अचि परे दिस यर हॅज एन अच होल उकार नाही बाल्टी म्हटलं पाणी. हां हां पाणी. सो उकार इज देअर. दिस उकार इज एन अच. So achi pare, what will happen? This yaraha dve na bhavataha. There is no nisheda sutra. So thereby chaturshu will not have shakara doubling. So that's a nisheda sutra. So that by that chatur is over. Now you have what? You have another shabda here, makaranta. Makaranta prasham shabda has been taken. Prasham. What is prasham? Prapurvaka shamu upashame dhatu plus quip. So you look at this what? You quip cha. So here you have prapurvaka sham plus quip anunasikasya kvijjalo bhiti. There is a, you look at akara becoming akara here, and then what else? Krutadya samasascha will give pratipadika sanya. So you have prasham. Prasham is the pratipadika now, and now there is a vidhi sutra. Mono dhatoho padasyante. Mono dhatoho makarasya naha adesha bhavati. कस्य मकारस्य धातोः मकारस्य. धातु मकार विल टेक नकार आदेश व्हेन इट इज एट द पदस्य अंते. देयरफॉर एट द एंड ऑफ द पद दिस धातु मकार व्हिच इज एट द एंड ऑफ द पद विल टेक नकार आदेश. देयरबाय व्हाट विल हैपन? प्रशा प्रशाम विल बिकम व्हाट? दिस मकार विल बिकम नकार. प्रशाम मकार इज बिकमिंग नकार. मोनो धातुः. दैट्स द विधि सूत्र. So how will this decline now? Prasham has become Prashan in, when you have this Prashan in Prathama Ekvachana. Because here there is, you look at Padante, only at the end of the Pada. When will you get this Padanta? Only after you added a Su Pratya. So Prasham plus Su, that time you will get Prasham only. But then after Sulopa, when this Makara is at the end of the Pada, because Su and this Sakara will go away. And still Prasham plus Su and Prasham are both Padas. Prasham plus su is a pada, and prasham will be a pada even after su goes away. By halnyabhyo dirgha sutsya pruktam hal lopa lupyate. Thereby nakara is the adesha by mono dhato. This dhatu makara which has survived at the end of the pada, that will take nakara adesha. So this is the case only in first case singular here now, right now. Then what will happen? Even with the padasanya, not by suptingantam pada, the first case singular is by suptingantam pada padasanya, but also in the asarunamasthana bhyam ityadi supratya paryantam, wherever you have this bhakara sakara at the beginning of the pratya, there also you will get padasanya and makara will become nakara because it is a padanta makara. See, look at this. We have seen the sutra nalop of pratipadikantasya. So this nalop of pratipadikantasya is also prapta. But there can also be an argument here. I'm just thinking aloud here. Nakara at the end of the pada is not at the end of the pratipadika. Pratipadika was prasha, makaranta. So, but still, some will say that this is prapta because this nakara, makara has changed into nakara. It is only an ekadesha. Vikrutam ananyavat, by that paribhasha, one will say prasham, prashan, both are same because only one part of the pratipadika has changed, and that will still mean this prashan makara was nakara also, and thereby nalop of pratipadika can also be seen as prapta. But what happens is that this will not see, one can say it is prapta, but what will happen? It is asiddha. Why is it asiddha? Because it occurs at 8 to 7 and this nakara form has not really cannot be seen by the 8 to 7 sutra. Because this our sutra 8 to 64 is mono dhatu. Makara becoming nakara has taken place only in 8 to 64, which is asiddha for 8 to 7, being earlier, being in Tripadi. So you have to go in sequence. Thereby, there is no application of nalop of pratipadika dasya. Otherwise, this makara, which would have otherwise been seen as nakara, would have taken lopa. That doesn't happen. Then substana, what will happen in saptami ekvachana? Prasham, makara will become nakara, monodhato. Then nascha, sidhut, va. So optional, there is a dhudagama. We saw in the last part, this dhakara causes what? Some other sandhi sutras may apply. But here, kharicha. Kharicha, sakara, this kharas, sakara will cause this dhakara to become char. Chartvam. So dhakara becomes takara, then you have prashant su. Pakshe meaning what? This dhudagama is vibhasha. So if you do not apply dhudagama, then this su sakara is khar, which is following nakara directly. So just varna milna prashansu. So prashansu is one form, prashansu is another form. Pakshe, should not write this. Pakshe, so prashansu is second form. So thereby makaranta is also done in pullinga. At least one. Then kim is also makaranta. So this kim, pratipadika kim, what, who, all this meaning can be there. In pullinga, it can mean who also, what also. So, kimak kaha. Kimak kaha. So, how does this kim decline in pullinga? Kaha kau ke. So, how do you get kaha kau ke declension? How does kim become ka? So, kaha kau ke is the declension. In feminine, you will get ka ke kaha. So, kaha kau ke. So, in sarva, we have seen this ke. So, we may understand ke, how sarvaha sarvo sarve. As opposed to Ramaha, Ramo, Ramaha, Sarva in Pullinga, in Prathama Bahuvachana, does not become like Ramaha, it becomes Sarve, Ekara is there. So we can understand this K form only when we think of this Ka is the Pratipadika, but Pratipadika happens to be Kim. So what happens? It's a Makaranta Halanta. Halanta, how does Halanta declare Ka Kauke? For that, the Vidhi Sutra is Kimakaha. So kimaha kimiti pratipadikasya kaha iti adesha hoti kada hoti vibhakto upare. When there is a vibhakti following, that time you get a ka adesha. So ka adesha. But if you look at it, ka is a multiletter adesha, kakara and akara adesha is there. Therefore, it is a anekal shit sarvasya. It is an anekal adesha, not shit, but anekal. So, anekal will become nimitta for entire kim to be replaced by ka. Thereby, entire kim, kim, makara, ikara has not become akara, but kim has been replaced by ka. So, you'll get kaha kau ke. Kim akasya vibhaktopare. So, vibhaktopare means when all the cases are following, then it will take place. Therefore, kim plus su, you'll get ka plus su, and then rutto visarga will give you kaha kaha. Similarly, kau ke shesham sarvavat. And we have seen this pronoun sarva. So, it will be like sarva through and through. Kaha kau ke kam kau kaan ityadi. So, just one additional sutra. If you know sarva declension in pullinga, just one additional sutra, kima ka vibhakto will give you the kim also. Then what happens with idam? That is also pronoun, so vidhi sutra. Idam, idam o maha, sau, sau pare. When su pratyaya follows, then idam will take idamaha, maha adesha hoti. Maha adesha. And here, maha adesha, here you look at this, is a makara adesha. Akara is only for pronunciation, so it is a makara adesha. You cannot say makara in first case. You cannot decline like marut. Marut. Marut can be declined, but just marut, takara cannot be declined. Similarly, makara cannot be declined. You cannot pronounce it. It can be declined. You can say makara. But you cannot pronounce this makara. Therefore, a is for pronunciation. Akara is ucharanartha. Thereby, makara is a single letter adesha. If it is a single letter adesha, then idamaha ma, if you do, what will happen? See, makara is substituted in the place of last letter of idam when su follows. So why do you replace makara of idam with makara? Because something else must have been there. And what is that? Makara is substituted in the place of last letter of idam when su follows. Tyadadi atva apavadaha. There was atva prapta. Tyadadi nam aha was there. So sadhana aha adesha is an atva. By taparakarana atva adesha was there. This atva adesha would have caused either idam makara to become akara. Instead, the makara adesha itself is there. So makara is the replacement for makara, meaning akara will not apply, and thereby you will get only makara. So makara will be retained. Idam will remain idam, and it will not have the atva adesha. So idam plus su, idamu maha, saupare, and that's not done. To be continued in the next sutra, another vidhi sutra is there. Idoi pumsihi. So ido pumsi saupare. Again, su pratyaya when it is following, pumsi. This su should be in pullinga. Only in pullinga when su follows, in prathama ekvachana, what will happen? This idam will take ayadesha. And what in idam will take ayadesha? Id. Id will take idaha. So idaha. Idamaha ida, because idam will be there, which id will take. So if you look at it, 7211, just let me look through this sutra here. 7211. So 7211 is our sutra, idoi pumsi. So this idoi pumsi, if you look at it, this idamaha is also there. Idamaha ma, this idamaha goes till 113, our sutra is 111. So in anurti it will be easier. See, it strikes you when you are looking at the anurti. Some is written, which ida, ida. So we don't know what is this. So idamaha, there is anurti. This should be added here. Idamaha. Idamaha is qualifying this idaha. So idamaha idaha ai adesha bhavati pumsi saupari. When a pullinga supratya prathama ekvachana pratyaya follows, then pullinga meaning in the pullinga sense, because the pratiparika is pullinga, then only the su is all su aujas are in all genders, but you will identify which gender by the pratyaya also. You will say because it is added, this su is added to a masculine or a feminine, then you will say that this is masculine or feminine. Just like latlakara, if you say latlakara tip pratyaya, that can be differentiated. Hopefully soon we'll land into tinganta derivation, which will be more interesting. Why more interesting? Because it has more usage. Even if you study Subanta with as many sutras as possible, still you will have a lot to do for each and every form of each and every gender. with each and every kind of an ending, and we have not yet landed on the pratyaya ending. There will be pratyaya endings also. Matup ending will have some other form, ini ending some other form. So all these will have specific rules. But in Tinganta, although there are so many dhatus with 10 lakaras, with parasmai, atmanepadi, samvaru, ubhayapadi, and then this kartari, karmani, prayoga, bhave prayoga, but still it is all having a shortcut method by few sutras. So there are less number of sutras which will give you a lot of mileage in derivation of Tinganta. And why I brought the contest is because I wanted to mention that when you say tip or anything pratyaya, tip pratyaya, tas pratyaya, ta pratyaya, atam pratyaya, you have to find out as to what it was a replacement for. So tiptas ji siptas, all this sutra, that sutra follows the lasya sutra, and lasya kasya, lasya is lakarasya, kidrasya lakarasya, that should be seen. So your akamsha is which lakara has been replaced by ting pratyaya. So if you see ti pratyaya is prathama, prathama purushaha ekavachana pratyaya. So this tip pratyaya has been a replacement for lakara, which is what kind of lakara? It is a lat lakara, lang lakara, lit lakara, which lakara? With that question, you have to see the pratyaya. Similarly here, the su pratyaya is also seen as pumsi or napumsi ityadi. So ay adesha. So you come back to idam. What happens is idam, idamaha, idaha ay. So this, look at this anuvritti. You see idam has been used in the anuvritti by lagukara. So what happens? Idi will be replaced by ay, and therefore idam will decline as ayam in prathama ekvachana. Sorry, there are kids playing. Although we are on the fourth floor, still the kids, kids voice reaches all floors. Swarga paryantam. So here you look at this. Idamaha id is replaced by ay. You will get ayam. So you get ayam as prathama ekvachana in masculine. In feminine you get iyam. So we'll see that later. This is a sutra whereby idam declines as ayam. Then what happens when you add au? For that there is another sutra. Before that, what? Idam plus au. Here there is no apavada to tedanam aha vibhakto. So when vibhakti follows, idam makara is replaced by adadesha means aha, aha, which was seen as atva apavada earlier. There is no apavada to this sutra like the earlier case. Therefore, you will get idam will become ida plus a plus au. Now, there is a Vidhi Sutra ordained Atogune. So, Atogune, what is Prapta here? If you look at it, Ida, Akara and Akara, what should have happened? So, the Ayam form, here the Ida, Ay, or earlier also Ida, Mahama, these are Apua for Atua, meaning Tyadadinam, A. But for Idam plus Au, there is no such Apavada. Therefore, Idam plus Au has become either a au. Now atogune does not let there be akas savarna dirgha prapti. Savarna dirgha does not take place, and in prakriya avastha atogune, because apadantat pararupam ekaha purva parayo samitayam. So samitayam vishaye kim bhavati, purva parayo ho ekaha adesha bhavati. Kasa adesha, puro parayoho ekaha pararupa adesha. So pararupa adesha, pararupa when ato gune. So when there is ataha gune, saptami ekvachana. So when a guna letter is following, akara is following, short akara is followed by a guna letter, a or o. And in our case, what is following? There is a guna letter. A is a guna letter. It is following akara, ida akara. So what is happening is this, ida akara. Ida, akara, there is an id and akara here. Guna letter is also a. So ato gune, when, so panchami and saptami are disagreeing with each other as to which is sthani. Each calls out the other as sthani, and panchami is baliya. Thereby this akara is the would have been the sthani. But we don't have an issue here. Why? Because puro pareyo, both are going to be replaced. So they both to become sthani, and they are going to be replaced by which? Pararupa. Therefore this guna akara, this akara is the replacement for both ida akara plus the a which is following. Therefore you will get ida plus a will be ida. So both of these together will be replaced by a single akara, which is this second, this akara itself is the adesha akara. And thereby, still it is not done. Pararupa is the adesha. So not at the end of the pada, meaning in prakriya avastha. Not at the end of the pada, meaning the pada, it is not derived yet. In the prakriya avastha, apadanta, this ida akara and followed by guna akara has a guna akara following pararupa as ekadesha. Then there is another vidhi sutra. So many sutras for idam. That's why it's difficult to see as in and in different genders it will decline differently. So dascha vibhakto idamaha maha dascha. So vibhakto idamaha ma. Earlier we have seen idamaha ma. Idam makara is retained as makara, that's what it means. Adesha is there, makara. So but in end result is what idam makara is replaced, is expected to be left alone as makara. There is no other replacement needed there. Vibhaktau pare. So what happens? Dascha vibhaktau pare, when there's a vibhakti following, then there is a makara adesha dascha, and dascha is said. Dascha makara. So thus if you look at this, daha. Daha is what? Shashti ekvachana. So daha idamaha. Idamaha dascha of the dakara. Idamas dakara. Idam dakara. There is a makara desha. So now this idamaha maha, it is extended. Makara is replaced by makara. But it has already been replaced by akara by tadadinam aha. So dascha will cause the dakara of idam also to become makara. So what will happen now? You are deriving this idam plus au, so tyadadinam aha has made makara to become akara. Then what has happened? Just give me a moment, please. Sorry, so we'll have these interruptions because the maid has her own time. So she comes in at whatever time, and since if she has to clean here, I have to set aside. Okay, set aside myself. So idam makara has become akara by tyadadinam vibhakto pare. Then what has happened? This ato gune has caused this akara and ida akara followed by akara in prakriya avastha apadanta to become Eka Rupa Guna Adesha, that following para a Guna Adesha, so Eka Adesha. So this is the Adesha here. So Ida plus A has remained as Ida. Then now Dascha is causing this Dakara to become Makara. So Ida has become Ima now. And then you will get Varna Melana Imau. So much has gone for Prathama Dvivachana or Dvitiya Dvivachana of Idam plus Au. Over out. Then, so ayam, imo, ime. How do you get ime? Of course, I mean, there is another vriddhirechi is applying after negating prathameva purva savarna by nadichi. So nadichi negates prathameva purva savarna, and then vriddhirechi comes in, and this h aukara is causing vriddhi with this ima akara. So echi pare vriddhi bhavati. So thereby imo. So how do you get ime? So idam plus jas, here what is happening? Jasha shi sarvanamna ataha. So jas is replaced by shi sarvanam, because it's sarvanamasthana, not sarvanamasthana, sarvanam, it's a pronoun. So here sarvanam is pronoun. So this pronoun jas is replaced by shi. So idam plus shi, What is happening now? Tyadadi nama, we have seen makara becomes akara. Then ato gune causes this ida and a to not take savarna dirgha but remain a. This is a replacement. So ida plus a has become ida. Now ida plus e, what is expected here now? So before ida plus e, again ima like earlier that dascha dakara becomes makara. So ima plus e. So ad guna expected is prathameva pura savarna negated by nadichi just like earlier. And then ad guna comes back just like vriddhirechi came back. So ime, this is prathama bahuvachana as well as ditiya bahuvachana. So ayam, imau, ime, and then see here you look at it, idam has, there is no table here, but if you, hopefully she'll have given at the end. Yeah, here. So if you look at it, just let's jump forward and you see. So many things are happening. Ayam, imau, ime. Idam is the pratiparika. But in second case, imam. Why this? Imam makara. Just like here, ima, dakara has become makara. So dascha sutra is applying. So dascha sutra will keep on applying where you see ima form. Where you see ayam form, there idaha I has applied. Where you see ima kind of form for idam, there dascha has applied. So you see all of these. But then not only that, third case you see anena, and dual you see abhyam, then you see abhi, so many sutras are applying. So those are going to be dealt with next. So you see here, as it is, pronouns are difficult. We have seen pronouns in sarva also. So you go back and continue. What happens here? Sorry, ime. So we have derived till ayam, imau, ime. In dvivachana and bahuvachana, in second case, in dvitiya, same forms are there. But dvitiya ekvachana, what happens? So there, of course, sambodhana is not there, being a pronoun here. So vidhi sutra. What is the vidhi sutra here? Anapyakaha chadadehe sambodhanam nasti. So anapyakaha, anapyaka is a sutra, vibhakto idamaha idaha. So this id of idam, earlier we had seen what adesha? Ay adesha. But here idamaha idaha vibhakto pare kaha adesha. Here we have an adesha. An is the adesha. Api and akaha is there. Akaha is in also ak in shashti ekvachana. So idamaha idaha akaha api vibhakto an. What is aap? Api vibhakti. Aap is tap chap ityadi. So api, if you look at this, so this not tap chap, tap. So this tap, ta to sup vibhakti. So this aap is, this is a pratyahara, a of ta and it of sup. So you put together, it's a pratyahara from what? You start with ta. Ta is what? Third case singular. And you go on till seventh case plural, where there is sup. So the short form of tap, and tap in saptami ekvachana will become tapi. So it's a pratyahara made of a sup segment of the sup pratyahas, tapi. Generally we see pratyaharas in of from Maheshwara sutras, but then there is a thing and sup pratyah, which is itself a pratyahara. It's a short form. Within the sup pratyah also there is a short form, just like sut. We see sut sudanapunsakasya. So there we see sut. Sut is a pratyahara. Similarly, tap is a pratyahara. Generally, when tap comes to mind, sealing a pratyah, tap, chap comes to mind. So that's why I blurted that out. But a correction, tap here is a pratyahara within the sup. It's a subset of sup. So api, and if you remove the takara, what happens? Api. That is the api, because ta content is a. So Bhagwan Sutrakara has called it as aap pratyah. So api pare. Parasaptami, so api pare, when any of the third case onwards pratyah follow, then what will happen? This idamaha id, which ak of the idama ik, will be replaced by an. So now so much has happened. What is idamaha id, which is idamaha id, and aka is also there. So aka is also there. Ak id of idam will take anadesha. See, look at akakarasya idamaha idaha an api vibhaktau. What does it mean? This then the ap pratya, any of the ap pratyas follows ta onwards, then you'll see anadesha. So idam id will be replaced by an. Ak is mentioned there, but what is being used is id itself is being mentioned there directly. Idaha anadesha. So akakarasya idamaha idaha an api vibhakto. So this third case singular to seventh case plural, in all those cases there is an anadesha. This is a nutsarga. So an is the adesha. So ida tyadadinam a ida, then ato gune ida plus a. This a is an ap. Therefore when ap follows, then ida id will take anadesha. So we'll get ida will become id will become an, and ida will become ana. So ana plus a, anapyakaha. By this anapyaka sutra, this is our sutra right now. Anekalshit sarvasya, entire id is replaced by an, because an is a multiliter adesha. Then what happens here now? Ana plus a, tam nyasignyasam inat syaha atahanga. This sutra we have studied earlier in Hari also. We get the same, a becomes ina, and then you will get ana plus ina will give you anena by adgunaha. So much for anena. Halilopaha, vidhi sutra, halilopaha, akaha, idamaha, idaha, api vibhakto, all those conditions are same, but halilopaha. When halilopaha vibhaktau, so haladi vibhaktau pare, you get tadadi vidhi, and when haladi pratyaya follows supratyaya, which supratyaya? Aap. In the aap segment, third case onwards, whenever there is a hal at the beginning of the vibhakti, then lopaha, kasya lopaha bhavati, idaha lopaha, ida is sthani. So idam ida will take lopa, that is what is being said. So what will take lopa? Idam id will take lopa. So now you look at the derivation idam. So bhyam su ityadi sthana are what? Are haladi vibhakti pare pratyas. So thereby what haladi pratyas, therefore what happens is idam tyadadi nama has caused makara dvika kara, then ato gune ida, together is ida, there is no savarna dirgha. Now this ida id is replaced by what? Lopaha, idaha lopaha. So what will take lopa here? Akaha idamaha api vibhakto lopaha, idamaha lopa api halado, and you look at lopa in the place of id when haladi ap pratyaya follows. So paribhasha, there is a paribhasha, na anarthake alontya vidihi anabhyasa vikare. So what is the paribhasha? Says that what is the paribhasha? Lopa should take place for the last letter, alontya vidhi, alontyasya. So alontyasya, here this paribhasha does not work except for modification abhyasa. When there is an abhyasa, then anabhyasa vikare does not work except for anabhyasa vikare. So what will happen? Thus all the letters of ida are to be elided. There is a lopa for all the letters. There is no antyadesha. So ida dakarasya lopa itina. All of them should go. Hali lopa. So there are so many other exceptions to this, whether this supicha is applicable, etc. So what will happen? This entire id, idaha id will go away. So actually this, not this, here ida, akara and akara put together, there has been ato gune. So ida, this ida is what? Id and akara. So this id will be taken out completely, and then a will remain. So a plus bhyam, you should get abhyam. What is the form? Abhyam. So there is a paribhasha sutra, adyantavad ekasmin. Adyantavad ekasmin meaning an effect can take place on a single letter, like what? Adi or anta. Adi antavat. So adi is antavat. In a similar paribhasha we had seen earlier, this paribhasha sutra is quoted. But what is the application? Ekasmin kriyamanam karyam adav iva ante iva syat. So what is working at the beginning of something, that is at the end of the other also. So thereby what happens is supicha, this for supicha iti dirgha, there is a supicha dirgha. So you look at the supicha, suprate, so also supicha is supicha applicable. So what I said is that supicha is applicable abhyam, the supratyaya is followed, supicha dirgha bhavati, and thereby what will happen is that iti dirgha, supicha iti dirgha, it takes place on which letter? A. So this A is the anga, just like on the last letter of any anga, by what? Adyanta or ekasmin. So it will work on this A. What is this A really? This A is anta of ida, adyanta vat ekasmin, and therefore in a single letter this adi also anta also. So what will take dirgha? If you say adi will take dirgha or anta will take dirgha, for both A is adi also anta also, it is a single letter, therefore adyanta vad ekasmin, in a single letter it itself the adi also anta also, supicha will cause dirgha, and thereby as an anta you can see it will take dirgha, A will become a. So after halilopa supicha will cause dirgha. Atha adantasya angasya. By paribhashita adyanta vad ekasmin, A will become A, and thereby abhyam is the rupa siddhi for all 3, 4, 5 case dual. So 3rd, 4th, 5th case dual. So much for this idam. It's still not over. We'll continue in the next part on Wednesday with the next sutra, which is a Nisheda sutra. With idam plus bhis, what happens? We'll see a Nisheda sutra next. Tavasane Nataraja Rajo Nana Dadakkano Panchavaram Uddharatu Kamasanakadi Siddhani Katvitad Vimarshe Shiva Sutra Jalam. Sorry for the interruption, but then please bear with this. I am also outside my house at my brother's place, so whatever interruptions are there, we'll try to continue. Have some patience. Namaste. Dhanyavada.
Namaste.